This monstrous boy is Onyx. I have to tell you, I've been rescuing since 2004, and we've placed over 2,100 dogs, and this, at least weight and frame-wise, is the biggest dog we've ever had in the program. We had one before named Grizzly. He was a red and white. He weighed 130 pounds. This guy weighs 145, and he is not overweight. I mean, that's
he's perfect. He's not.
Yeah, he's very fit, very well. He's been well taken care of. So he is a giant Alaskan Malamute. They breed them intentionally this way. Of course, you know, the AKC and the breed standard are not supportive of that because, you know, they're breed standards for a reason. But people do like these really big guys, and he is, wow, one of them. He went out with one of our volunteers. He went into foster 3 months ago. The guy had him 2 days, and he had fostered for us before, including a Malamute, had him 2 days and said he's staying. So we never did post him originally, and he had been with that family for the last 3 months. They have two boys, 8 and 13, a wife who's somewhat diminutive, and I mean, everything has gone swimmingly with them. They said he's normally a gentle giant who enjoys lounging around and being near the family. He rarely barks, but has been known to howl when the house is empty for a bit before he settles down. Once comfortable, he's quite affectionate and gentle. Now, I'm going to say he is very nervous with us right now. He has lost that home, which we'll get into in a minute. He's been to one vet, returned to the home, been to our vet for medical testing because he's got an infection going on, and now here he is back at the kennel. So this is a nervous dog whose world has been turned completely upside down, and I mean, you can just see he doesn't know what the heck has happened. Again, he said, lived with an 8 and a 13-year-old. He loved attention from both the boys and had no problems. With regard to strangers, he said, as long as the family is calm, he'll be calm. Here's the deal with him. It's been kind of a perfect storm of circumstances. He has a painful infection. He was displaying signs of an infection and pain. The family wanted to try and foster, and we appreciate it, try and foster a female Malamute mix. So she was introduced into the home, and their vet had prescribed Xanax for him because he once grumbled at a vet tech, so they gave a prescription for Xanax. The family mistakenly thought giving Xanax might help the introductions between Onyx and the female Malamute mix they wanted to foster. And with the Xanax, he did display aggression that he never had before. They have two boys and were understandably concerned about that, so they have brought him back. But if you Google canines and Xanax, and the family didn't know this, it is a very, very common reaction. I mean, Xanax is a psychotropic drug. It affects the brain. And, oh, look at you, how handsome you are. You see over and over that dogs who have never been aggressive, you give them Xanax and they act out aggressively. So between the fact that he was stressed from, and she was a big dog, stressed from another dog being there, has something painful and rectal going on and an infection, so he didn't feel well. And then they threw the Xanax on top of that. It just really did not set him up to do well in that situation. So just to be on the safe side, we really are confident this behavior was just an aberration based on all those circumstances. We will want to place him, he's a big dog, place him with someone with Malamute experience. We don't want to place him with kids just because if there's been any sign, you would need to be wary and manage him being nervous or so forth, that we want an experienced adult home to adopt him. But the family, again, had him for 3 months. He was just a big baby. Before the Malamute that they tried, in the past few weeks, they fostered a 12-week-old Siberian Husky puppy. And Onyx was just a big baby with her. I mean, they had pictures of her crawling on him and him like gently pawing at her and him kind of hanging back and rolling his eyes like, God, she's getting on my nerves, Dad, but never did it. I mean, he was absolutely perfect with her. So he is really nervous and confused right now. And he deserves to go to a place where he never finds himself in uncertain circumstances again. He said, he likes to chew on certain toys, but isn't a ball or tug or fetch kind of dog. His favorite was a big, thick yellow donut. He also likes raw bones from the butcher, and that's not surprising. Said he enjoys running, playing around in the yard, play in general. He was just getting to be okay with car rides, so the plan was for some park time. As he was very skittish initially, we were giving him plenty of time to adjust first. Again, he talked about living with the female husky puppy. He said, I believe he could be okay with other dogs. He had lived with some before, but I'm unsure of how that interaction went. Finding a larger dog to see how he reacts might be difficult. Well, yeah. Because again, I mean, Grizz was the biggest ever, and he came in second to this dude. The foster pup showed significant dominant traits, but he didn't care. And she probably did, too. It was a little female husky. The other foster dog was very mild-mannered, but he did not like her at all. Maybe adult dogs are that specific one, or he was sick, though I don't have enough sample data to give a better determination. And again, he clearly was not feeling well. While in the kennel, he was parked next to Stassi, who is she's half his size, but she's a pretty strong-willed female Malamute, said she barked at him nonstop, but he totally ignored her. He said, he has seen cats, otherwise he's not around them. We asked about chasing small animals. He said he went running when two cats bolted across the field. This guy lived out in the country. Sometimes he chases squirrels, sometimes birds. He hunts moles, but isn't very good at it. He has been a totally inside dog. He's got fantastic house manners. Said he lives indoors and likes to lay next to the big registers for the air conditioning. When it cools down outside, so he likes the cool air. When it cools down outside, he gladly hangs out in the yard with the family. Sleeps in the house wherever he feels like sleeping. There were just no limitations on him. Said at night he comes to the master bedroom unless he's hot, and then he just sleeps by a vent. Totally housebroken and has had free run of the house at all times when they were home and when they were not at home. We asked if he was destructive and he said no, but he is easily counter height and likes to eat. He's been known to snatch food if you aren't looking or he thinks it's been out too long. And boy, if this guy wants to counter surf, there's not a counter he can't reach. They had a welded wire 4-foot fence over 3 acres. He said anytime he's outside, he's taken out on a leash with a family member. If he's released from the leash, he understands he's free to roam the yard with his person. He has never made an escape effort. He knows the boundaries and didn't spend much time exploring them for ways to get away. This may be different in smaller yards, but he's not a jumper. However, I wouldn't put it past him not to go after a deer if one bolted in front of him. He is faster and more agile than one would expect if they just watched his casual lope around the house. At speed, he sounds like cavalry approaching, and I bet he does. He knows to sit and stay, and he knows what paw means, but really prefers not to give him. He won't protest if you take his paw, though. He knows go, which would release command from the leash, and come. He knows barn and house for places to go. He knows outside, inside. He knows lie down, but hasn't really shown much interest, even with high-value treats. So he's a Malamute and kind of does things when he feels like doing them pretty much. He also knows at feeding time to sit and wait for food. We ask about leash manners. He said, I had planned to have him fitted for a harness to pull as a way to exercise. And a lot of people do that with Malamutes. They, you know, hook him up with a harness and have him pull the tire and so forth. I still feel like he would do well with that. He was just starting to be okay getting in the car without a bribe or me lifting him up. I don't advise this as he's pretty heavy. He's not there yet, but with some work, I believe he would be okay. As far as phobias, he said he was very skittish when he came to the rescue and when we first got him home. Everything had him jumpy, and I don't necessarily feel he had a good experience with the male owner as he was head shy initially and would do submissive peeing when I ran up one day outside. Very slow movements and reassurance got him much more comfortable. He was very scared of moving vehicles of any type and would not go near the fence line by the street. However, in the last month, he had become really quite comfortable and would only run from the fence with large trucks or really loud things. He showed no fear from thunder or fireworks or gunfire. He said, I live in the country kind of gunfire, not the city kind of gunfire. He needs a calm and slow integration to his next home. Let me pause for a minute and look at these notes. Okay, he said he needs regular brushing weekly with intermittent brushing during the week. This is a 45-minute process, at least for weekly. He has, I mean, they have done a great job with his coat. His coat's beautiful. There's absolutely no undercoat. And a dog this size, you want to get as much of that hair out of there in a curl-controlled situation as you can. Said he's let me brush his teeth a little bit recently, but that's something we were working on. He does not like having his nails cut. It takes time. I've only managed to cut one at a time. He's so big that holding the paws steady when he doesn't want to can be a task. He loves bananas and peanut butter. He's stolen bananas and ate a bunch of five, peeled the bananas. Smart boy. Once. He doesn't beg at the table, but will just hang out with the family. He may try to lick the entire table afterwards if he thinks nobody is watching. His only bad reactions at the vet were sick pet visits. His initial visit with the vet went fine. This is a fantastic dog. He's on pain medication right now. Bev wanted to point that out too, because since he had the reaction to the one medication. So he's just, his world's been upended once and then again and then again, and here he is. So we know that person with the experience out there and the patience to let them feel. It seems funny when, you know, you look at a dog this big and say they're scared and need to feel safe, but he doesn't know how big he is, and he's scared and needs to feel safe. So that's what we're going to be looking for. He doesn't, the only treat he liked was a cheese, so.
Do they know how old he is?
I think about three.
Three?
Yeah, about three. He does weigh 145 pounds, and again, that is a healthy 145 pounds. He is not overweight. He is a big, strong boy. So, oh, he's eating that now. I bet he'd eat the, let me pause and get the cheese. Okay, I'm going to video him taking treats because he takes them really nicely. Here we go. Such a good boy. That one's a little older, but it's still crappy. He didn't want the healthy one, like the lamb's lungs or whatever. He wants like the crappy ones. He wants the junk food. They're pretty old too. Hi, how about this one? Look at that face. Look at that face. Want that one? No? Oh, yes? Okay. Gosh, really soft mouth taking those treats. He's looking at Uncle Jack.